intercede with him who was born of you for much more of the supplications of a mother able to incline and ask with your kind heartedness. Despise not the prayers of sinners, O all true ones, but he who condescended to suffer for us is merciful and strong to save. Let your tender mercies quickly go before us, for we depend on you as a poor. Help us, O God, our Savior, for the sake of the glory of your name. O Lord, deliver us and cleanse us from our sins for your name's sake. Holy God, holy mighty, holy mortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy mortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy mortal, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. O most holy Trinity, have mercy on us, Lord, cleanse us from our sins. Master, pardon our transgressions. Holy One, visit and heal our infirmities for your name's sake. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one.
For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen. You were transfigured upon the mount, O Christ our God, revealing your glory to your disciples as much as they were able to bear, so that when they saw you crucified, they would know it voluntarily and proclaim to the ends of the earth that you are the light of the Father. Lord of mercy, 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 Lord of mercy. Lord of mercy, 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 Lord of mercy. O Christ God, worship and glorify you every season and in every hour in heaven and on earth. Long suffering, deep with compassionate, and great and merciful, who loves the just and shows mercy upon the sinner, who calls all men to salvation through the promise of blessings to come. Accept, O Lord, our prayers at this hour, direct our lives according to your commandments. Sanctify our souls, cleanse our bodies, order our minds, purify our thoughts, and deliver us from all affliction, evil, and sickness. Help us, as above, with your holy angels, that guard and guide by their regions. We may retain it to your faith and the knowledge of your unapproachable glory. Give your blessing and gracious of ages. Amen. Lord of mercy, Lord of mercy, Lord of mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. More honorable than the cherubim, and more glorious beyond compare than the seraphim. Without you, Father, we give thanks to God, the word of truth, and our purpose we magnify. In the name of the Lord, Father, bless.
Through the prayers of our holy fathers, O Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy upon us.
Amen. O God, the Lord of hosts and fashioner of all creation, who in your incomparable tender mercy sent down your only begotten Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, for the salvation of our time, and through this precious cross tore up the handwriting of our sins, thereby triumphing over the principalities and powers of darkness. O Master and Lover of mankind, accept these prayers of thanksgiving and supplication from us sinners, and deliver us from every deadly and dark transgression, and from all the visible and invisible enemies who have sought to do us harm. Nail our flesh with the fear of you, and let not our hearts incline to evil words or thoughts. But wound our souls with your love, that ever gazing upon you, guided by your light, and beholding you, the eternal light that no man can approach, we may send up unceasing praises and thanks to you, the Father in heaven, together with your only begotten Son, and your all holy good and life creating Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages. Amen.
Thank you.
the King, the Comforter, the Spirit of Truth, Lord, who are present in full soul things, the treasury of blessings and the giver of life, come and abide in us and cleanse us from every impurity and save our souls, O good Lord. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace among men of good will. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace among men of good will. O Lord, open thou my lips, and my mouth shall show forth thy praise. Blessed is the kingdom of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. In peace let us pray to the Lord. For the peace from above and for the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord. For the peace of the whole world, for the welfare of the holy churches of God, and for the union of all, let us pray to the Lord. For this holy house and those who do with faith, reverence, and the fear of God, let us pray to the Lord. The honorable priest of the Advent in Christ, for all the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord. For the president of our country, for all civil authorities, and for our armed forces everywhere, let us pray to the Lord. For our abbess, Mother Christophora, and for the sisterhood of this holy monastery, let us pray to the Lord. For this city, for every city, village, and country, and for the faithful dwelling in them, let us pray to the Lord. For seas of all weather, for the abundance of the fruits of the earth, and for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord. For travelers by land, sea, and air, for the sick and the suffering, for captives and their salvation, let us pray to the Lord. For our deliverance from all affliction, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace. Commemorating our most holy, most pure, most blessed and glorious Lady Theotokos, and ever Virgin Mary with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and our life unto Christ our God. Lord, our God, thy powers beyond compare, thy glory cannot be understood, thy mercy cannot be measured, thy love for man cannot be expressed. Look down on us and upon this holy house with pity, O Master, and impart the riches of thy mercy and thy compassion to us and to those who pray with us. For to thee are due all glory, honor, and worship, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Again, you. mercy on us and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Commemorating our most holy, most holy Mother, most blessed and glorious Lady Theotokos, and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints. Let us commend ourselves and each other and our life unto Christ our God. Lord our God, save thy people and bless thine inheritance. Preserve the fullness of thy church. Sanctify those who love the beauty of thy house. Glorify them and return by thy divine power. And forsake us not who put our hope in thee. For thine is the majesty, and thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Amen. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Praise the Lord, O my soul. I need to praise the Lord, O my life. To my God, as long as I live, do not put your trust in men in power, or in any mortal man, for he cannot save. He yells his breath and goes back to the earth he came from, and on that day all his schemes perish. The Lord is forever. Thank you.
Thank you.
Christo.
From Cunanon in the first home, let thy mercy, O Lord, be upon us, as we have set our hope on thee. Let thy mercy, O Lord, be upon us, as we have set our hope on thee.
The reading is from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Luke.
Glory to you.
Let us attend. And at that time, as Jesus was coming near Jericho, that a certain blind man sat by the road begging, and hearing a multitude passing by, he asked what it meant, and they told him that Jesus of Nazareth was passing by. And the man cried out, saying, Jesus, Son of David, have mercy upon me. And those who went before warned him that he should be quiet, but he cried out all the more, Son of David, have mercy upon me. So Jesus stood still and commanded him to be brought to him. And when he had come near, he asked him, saying, what do you want me to do for you? And the man said, Lord, that I may receive my sight. Then Jesus said to him, receive your sight, your faith has made you well. And immediately he received his sight and followed him, glorifying God. And all the people, when they saw it, gave praise to God. People who are in need have been in need since the beginning of time. But Christ even told us that you're always going to have the poor with you. And this one particular day, this one man was sitting by the road, listened to a commotion that was kind of not the usual type of commotion. Seemed to be a lot of extra hustle and bustle going on. So he called out to somebody, said, hey, what's going on? And they told him that Jesus of Nazareth was coming by. So then he yelled out, Jesus, Son of David, have mercy upon me. Now most people at that time wouldn't use that term. They wouldn't say, Jesus, Son of David, have mercy upon me. There had to be an extra understanding in this man about the vision of God. That's exactly what St. Cyril of Jerusalem had said. He said he looked and said there was a special quality about this man, that he knew that there was a holiness that was there. He understood and knew the holiness of God. And he was not maybe physically blind, but spiritually he wasn't, because he had this knowledge and this inner knowledge and understanding that this truly was the Messiah. This was truly the Son of David, the Son of God, the promised Messiah. Otherwise, as the saint said, he would not have been able to say it. He would not have even been able to think it. So he kept on crying out, Jesus, Son of David, have mercy upon me. And the people got disgusted with him. He said, keep quiet. You know, we don't want you to be around here. We're sitting here. We're with Jesus. You know, we're with God. We want to hear what he has to say. Please don't bother us. You know, you're nothing. And that's a terrible thing to understand. You know, especially from human nature. When one person can say that someone is nothing. One writer even put it to a point that he said that the people considered the blind man essentially nothing. That's all. He was just there. They had no feelings about him one way or another. There was no compassion, there was no mercy, there was no forgiveness, there was no caring about him, absolutely nothing. He was just something that was there, or somebody that was there, that had to be tolerated because he was blind and because he couldn't contribute anything to society. So they just simply let him be and didn't say too much to him. But that's a terrible thing, you know, even in the world today, to look at somebody and say, you know, you're really not essential. You're really not that important in life. We have other better things to do. We want to be with God. We want to be here. We want to be with the, quote unquote, you know, the in-group. We don't need you to be doing what you're doing. And so often, people in our society just kind of fall by the wayside. They just kind of quietly slip away. They slip into a very, very quiet existence, and they live their life not being very, very happy, but being very sad. Always kind of being felt that they weren't good enough to be part of the group. They weren't good enough to be part of the society because there was something that was physically wrong with them. That's a terrible thing. It really, really is. I've seen people over the years who have been physically sick. In fact, I think one that you probably know, Larry Struble. Mother Xenia was his sister-in-law, who was here at the monastery at one time. And Larry was, you know, quadriplegic. Bright man. But he was not down. People would look at him and say, oh, he has to be pushed around in a wheelchair. What good can he give to society? What good could he give to anyone? Well, he was a great father. He was a good man. He was a great member of the church. He even served in a church council. He did things that he didn't allow what somebody else had to say to be the guardian or the director for what his life was going to be or what his life was not going to be. He had a severe problem, but he overcame it. He couldn't walk, he never did, of course. But he didn't allow it. He didn't allow someone else to come down on top of him and say that you're no good, that you can't contribute, you can't do anything. Well, it's the same thing with this blind man. He wouldn't stop. He just kept on saying, Jesus, Son of David, have mercy upon me. Until finally the Lord heard him. And he said, bring him here to me. And he asked him what he wanted, and he wanted his sight, and the Lord gave him his sight because of the faith. The man had persistence. He didn't stop. Just because somebody said, you know, you're no good, or you don't have the talent, you don't have the ability, you can't do this, so what are we supposed to do? You know, go crawl off into a corner somewhere and hide? Or simply keep on doing everything that we can do to the very best of our ability, to the very, very best of our knowledge. We want to become essential, in a sense. We want to become non-essential. So this is the most important thing, is that we have to not always accept what people say to us, or say about us, or even think about us, but we have to be within our own heart and our own mind to know basically who we are and what we are, and be happy with who we are. We're not going to be someone else. We're not going to always meet someone else's expectations of what we should be or what we shouldn't be. But that doesn't matter. As long as we have a positive relationship with God, we have a positive relationship with ourselves, that's the most important thing. As long as we're happy, as long as we have kind of like a joyous character to our life, then it really doesn't matter
what kind of situation that we're in. You know, one other aspect of this gospel was the words, actually, that the blind man said. He said, "Son of David, have mercy upon me." So he's asking for forgiveness. He's seeking out and he wants to repent. So part of this plea to God is not only to have his sight received back, but he also is repenting. He's seeking that repentance. He's asking for repentance. He's asking for forgiveness in much the very same way. And ultimately, Christ simply told him that your faith has allowed this miracle to happen. The man participated in his own kind of healing in that particular sense. So it's, you know, the same thing applies, I think, to all of us in the world that we live in today. We may be blind to a lot of people who are around us or to things. Maybe we don't always stop and care. We don't listen to what people have to say. We don't always see the need that other people have. And maybe it's time, maybe for the world to change to a point. Maybe it's time that we should start learning to care a little bit more about each other. Not only just to talk about it, not only just to quote gospels, quote epistles, etc., but to actually go out and do something. And to allow, you know, kind of good things to happen to our families, to our friends, to our neighbors. Get to know people. And the most important thing is that we give, and that we seek the forgiveness, that we seek repentance, that we seek the love of God. And as we do this, we begin to grow. We change. We change spiritually. We change inwardly. And we no longer become people who are frightened and cower and in fear or something like that, but we can stand up, you know, very simply and very humbly before God and thank Him for the gifts that we have received and continually pray. Be like the publican, you know, "Lord, have mercy upon me, a sinner." And constantly pray and constantly allow that to happen in our existence. So that a little bit this morning about the blind man, kind of maybe a little bit of an awakening for us to kind of maybe take our own blinders off in our interpersonal relationships with people, to become a little more caring, to become a little more knowledge, to show more mercy and compassion, and to show more love. Amen. Christ is there.
Yes, and shall be.
Let us lift all our soul of our mind. Let us say,
Lord, have mercy.
O Lord, almighty God of our fathers, we pray to thee, hear us and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Have mercy on us, O God, according to thy great goodness. We pray to thee, O Lord, hear us and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for his beatitude, our Metropolitan Tipon, for his Eminence, our Archbishop Nathaniel, for priests, deacons, and all other clergy, and for all of our brethren in Christ.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for the President of our country, for all civil authorities, and for our armed forces everywhere.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for our abbess, Mother Christophora, and for the sisterhood of this holy monastery, for their health and for their salvation.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for the blessed and ever memorable Holy Orthodox Patriarchs, for the blessed and ever memorable founders of this holy monastery, for all of our fathers and brethren, the Orthodox who poured this life before us in blessed memory, and the holy departed servants of God, the Archpriest Chris, Joshua, Charles, Yates, Christopher, Vern, Joseph, Georgine, Dahlia, Dorothy, Essie, Didi, Jerome, Amel, Virginia, Attila, Nora, Catherine, Alexandra, and Michael, who here and in all the world lie asleep in the Lord.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for mercy, life, health, peace, salvation, visitation, remission of sins to the servants of God, those who are in sickness, ill health, and in suffering, the servants of God, the Archpriest Kenneth, the Archpriest Andrew, Mary Fultini, Danielle, Hope, Wayne, Myla, Dorothea, Peter, Susanna, Matushka, Juliana, Debbie, Philip, Landon, Thomas, Christina, Linda, and Denise, and especially for those who are afflicted in spirit, or angry, despondent, unthankful, or unforgiving, for those who are addicted to food, alcohol, drugs, gossip, or any other soul-destroying passion, for their lifting up and relief, and for the pardon and remission of their sins.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for those who bring offerings and do good works in this holy and all venerable monastery, for those who labor, for those who sing, for all the people who are here present, who await thy great and rich mercy.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, our God, accept this fervent supplication of thy servants, and have mercy on us according to the multitude of thy mercy. Send down thy bounties upon us and upon all thy people, who await the rich mercy that comes from thee. For thou art a merciful God who loves mankind. To thee we ascribe glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Pray to the Lord, you catechumens.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us, the faithful, pray for the catechumens, that the Lord will have mercy upon them.
Lord, have mercy.
That he will teach them the word of truth.
Lord, have mercy.
That he will reveal to them the gospel of righteousness.
Lord, have mercy.
That he will unite them to his holy Catholic and Apostolic Church.
Lord, have mercy.
Help them, save them, have mercy on them, and keep them, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Bow your heads unto the Lord, you catechumens. Then with us to glorify thine honorable, majestic name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
All catechumens depart, depart, catechumens. All that are catechumens depart, let no catechumen remain. Let us, the faithful, again and again, in peace pray unto the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Wisdom, we thank you, Lord God of hosts, was the tamarisk worthy to stand even now before thy holy altar, to fall down before thy compassion for our sins and the errors of all thy people, and enable us also, whom thou hast placed in this service, by the power of thy Holy Spirit, blamelessly and without offense, in the pure witness of our conscience, to call upon thee at all times and in every place, and that hearing us, thou may be merciful to us, according to the multitude of thy great goodness. For to thee do all glory, honor, and worship, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages. Yet again in peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Wisdom, Again, oftentimes, we fall down before thee, O God, who loves mankind, that looking down upon our petition, thou art cleanse our souls and bodies from all defilement of flesh and spirit, and grant us to stand blameless without condemnation before thy holy altar. Grant also to those who pray with us, O God, growth in life and faith and spiritual understanding. Grant them to worship thee blamelessly with fear and love, to partake without condemnation of thy holy mysteries, and to be counted worthy of thy heavenly kingdom. That guarded always by thy might, we may ascribe glory unto thee, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Thank you.
His Beatitude the Most Blessed Tikhon, the Archbishop of Washington, Metropolitan of All America and Canada, Zeminus Nathaniel, Archbishop of Detroit, Archbishop of the Romanian Episcopate of America, for our Rabbi's Mother Christophora, and for the sisterhood of this holy monastery, may the Lord God remember his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages and ages. For the President of our country, for all civil authorities enabled by the American people, and for our armed forces everywhere, may the Lord God remember his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages. For the founders and the benefactors of this holy monastery, for all those who abide therein, for those who give help and aid, for those who are in sickness, ill health, and in suffering, for those who are in terrible situations due to war, hatred, and anger, and especially we pray for the well-being of Metropolitan Paul and Archbishop John. May the Lord God remember in his kingdom always, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. For those who are in the priesthood and monastic orders, the diaconate, for our subdeacons, readers, and servers, and for all you Orthodox Christians, may the Lord God remember you in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Good and life-creating spirit, now and ever, and in two ages
of ages. Peace be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
Let us love one another that with one mind we may confess.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, the Trinity, one in essence, and one divided.
The doors in wisdom, let us attend.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the Son of God, the only begotten of the Father before all ages, light of light, true God, begotten, not made, of one essence with the Father, by whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven, and was incarnate of the Holy Spirit in the Virgin Mary, and became man. And he was crucified for us under Pontius Pilate, and suffered and was buried. And on the third day he rose again, according to the Scriptures, and ascended into heaven, and sits at the right hand of the Father. And he shall come again with glory to judge the living and the dead, whose kingdom shall have no end. And in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father, who with the Father and the Son together is worshipped and glorified, who spoke by the prophets, in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church, I acknowledge one baptism for the remission of sins. I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come.
Amen. Let us stand aright, let us stand with fear, let us attend, that we may offer the Holy Oblation in peace. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you. Let us lift up our hearts.
We lift them up unto the Lord.
Let us give thanks unto the Lord.
Lord, the Son of God.
Christ who loves mankind, we also cry aloud and say, Holy art thou, and holy thou, and thine only begotten Son, and thy Holy Spirit. Holy art thou, and holy magnificent is thy glory, who has so loved thy world as to give thine only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. When he had come and fulfilled all the dispensation for us, in the night in which he was given up, or rather gave himself up for the life of the world, took bread in his holy, pure, and blameless hands, and when he had given thanks and blessed it, and hallowed it, and broken it, he gave it to his holy disciples and apostles, saying, Take, eat, this is my body which is broken for you, for the remission of sin.
Amen.
Likewise, the supper took the cup, saying, Drink of it, all of you. This is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sin. Sitting at the right hand, the second glorious coming. Thine own of thine own, we offer unto thee, in behalf of all and for
Among the first, remember, O Lord, is Beatitude of Metropolitan T1,
His Eminence our Archbishop Nathaniel, grant them for the holy churches, in peace, safety, honor, health, and length of days, to rightly define the word of thy truth.
Remember all your people.
Remember, Lord, the city in which we dwell, every city and country, those with faith, go in them. Remember, O Lord, travelers, my land, sea, and air, the sick and the suffering, captives in their salvation. Remember, O Lord, those who bring offerings and do good in the holy churches, those who remember the poor, and upon us all send forth thy mercies. And grant that with one mouth and one heart we may praise thine all honorable and majestic name, of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages. And the mercies of our great God and Savior, Jesus Christ, shall be with all of you. Having remembered all the saints again and again, in peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the precious gifts offered and sanctified, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
That our God loves mankind, receiving them upon his holy heavenly and ideal altar, as a sweet spiritual fragrance, will send down upon us in return his divine grace and the gift of the Holy Spirit. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our deliverance from all affliction, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, for thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
That the whole day may be perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
An angel of peace, a faithful guide, a guardian of our souls and bodies, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
Pardon and remission of our sins and transgressions, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
All things that are good and profitable for our souls and peace for the world, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
That we may complete the remaining time of our life in peace and repentance, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
A Christian ending to our life, painless, blameless, and peaceful, and a good defense before the dread judgment seat of Christ, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
Having asked for the unity of the faith and the communion of the Holy Spirit, let us commend ourselves and each other and our life unto Christ our God. Unto thee we commend our whole life and our hope, O Master who loves mankind. We ask, pray, and supplicate thee, make us worthy to partake of the heavenly and awesome mysteries of this sacred and spiritual table, with a pure conscience, for the remission of our sins, for the forgiveness of our transgressions, for the communion of the Holy Spirit, for the inheritance of the kingdom of heaven, for boldness towards thee, but not for judgment or condemnation. And make us worthy, O Master, that with boldness and without condemnation, we may dare to call upon thee, the heavenly God, as Father, and to say,
thank you.
the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Peace be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads unto the Lord. Thanks unto thee, O King invisible, who by thy measureless power did make all things, and in the greatness of thy mercy did bring all things from non-existence into being. Look down from heaven, O Master, upon those who have bowed their heads unto thee, for they have not bowed down to flesh and blood, but to thee, the awesome God. Who thou thyself, O Master, distribute these gifts that are here offered unto all of us for good, according to the individual need of each. Sail with those who sail, travel with those who travel by land and by air, heal the sick, O thou art the physician of our souls and bodies. Through the grace and compassion and love toward mankind, of thine only begotten Son, with whom thou art blessed together, with thine all holy, good, and life-creating Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages. And the Lord Jesus Christ, our God, out of thy holy dwelling place in the throne of the glory of thy kingdom, and come to sanctify us, while thou sitst on high with the Father, and are here invisibly present with us, and by thy mighty hand, be born unto us thy most pure body and precious blood, and through us, to all thy people. O God, cleanse thou me a sinner, and have mercy upon me. O God, cleanse thou me a sinner, and have mercy upon me. O God, cleanse thou me a sinner, and have mercy upon me. Let us attend. Holy things are for the holy.
Soul and body.
Lord be with you.
in the fear of God, and with faith and love, draw near.
Preserved by them in thy holiness, may I always remember thy grace, and live not for myself alone, but for thee, our Master and Benefactor, may I pass from this life in the hope of eternal life, and so attain to everlasting rest, where the voice of those who feast is unceasing, and the gladness of those who behold the unspeakable beauty of their countenance is unending. For you are the true desire and ineffable joy of those who love you, O Christ our God, and all creation sings your praise forever. Amen.
O God, save thy people, and bless thine inheritance.
Rebest in the true light, we have received the heavenly Spirit, we have come the true faith, therefore the blessed worship, the undivided Trinity, who has saved us.
Always, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen. Let our mouths be filled with your praise, O Lord, for you have counted us worthy to partake of your holy, divine, immortal pure, and life-creating mysteries. Preserve us in holiness, so that we may sing of your glory,
especially for the communion of thy most pure and life-creating mysteries. I pray thee, gracious lover of man, preserve me under thy protection, beneath the shadow of thy wings, enable me, even to my last breath, to partake worthily with a pure conscience of thy holy things, for the remission of sins and unto life eternal. For thou art the bread of life, the fountain of holiness, the giver of all good. To thee we ascribe glory with the Father and the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages. Amen.
Let us attend, having partaken of the divine, holy, most pure, immortal, heavenly, life-creating, and awesome mysteries of Christ, let us worthily give thanks unto the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Asking that the whole day may be perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless, let us commend ourselves and each other and our life unto Christ our God. Thank you, Master, loves mankind, benefactor of our souls, that thou hast made us worthy this day of thy heavenly and immortal mysteries. Make straight our paths, strengthen us in thy fear. Guard our life, and make firm our steps through the prayers and intercessions of the glorious Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary, and of all thy saints. Without our sanctification, to thee we ascribe glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Let us depart in peace.
In the name of the Lord.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
O Lord, bless those who bless thee, and sanctify those who put their trust in thee. Save thy people and bless thine inheritance. Preserve the fullness of thy church, sanctify those who love the beauty of thy house, glorify them and return by thy divine power, and forsake us not who put our hope in thee. Give peace to thy world, to thy churches, to all thy priests, to those of civil authority, to all thy people, for every good gift and every perfect gift is from above, coming down from thee, the Father of lights. To thee we ascribe glory, thanksgiving, and worship, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Amen. Blessed be the name of the Lord, his Lord, and forevermore. Blessed be the name of the Lord, his Lord, and forevermore. Blessed be the name of the Lord, his Lord, and forevermore.
God to ages of ages. Glory to thee, O Christ, our God and our hope. Glory to thee.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. In the name of the Lord, Father, give the blessing.
May he who arose from the dead Christ and took up the prayers of his most holy mother, our mother among the saints, Xenia of St. Petersburg, Xenia of Rome, Gerasim, John, Babylas, and the companion martyrs and saints, whose memory we celebrate today, of St. John Chrysostom, whose liturgy we celebrate, the holy righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, and of all the saints, have mercy on us and save us, for as much as he is good, and the lover of mankind.
Morning, and we welcome all of you. I also want to extend a welcome to those of you who might be snowed in by the terrible storm and blizzard and not able to go to church, or the church not able to have the liturgy today. So I'm assuming that more people are watching this morning than normal, but it's nice to have you, and we do greet all of you in the feast of St. Xenia of Petersburg. Probably a good saint to have today to help us dig in, to help everyone dig out from the snow. We have no snow here in Elwood City. We're a little far west and north of, or a nor'easter to hit us, but we are thinking of you and praying for your good safety and strength. I know there are people stuck in less than convenient places, and many people in the cars on the Pennsylvania Turnpike. I can only imagine what that's like. It is a feast. St. Xenia did live for 45 years outside in St. Petersburg, and she knows what it is to be cold in snow. So she'll be praying for everyone. This past week, we commemorated 25 years of the passing of our Mother Alexandra, a monastery foundress. We had a very nice little gathering here on Thursday on her 25th anniversary of repose. So we do ask you to continue to pray for Mother Alexandra, and I'm sure she will pray for us. So have a blessed day and a blessed week. Everyone's here is invited to coffee hours. As usual, we have liturgy this week on Wednesday, and then on Saturday for the Feast of the Three Hierarchs.
Master Christ, our God, King of the ages, maker of all things, I thank thee for all the good things thou hast given me, especially for the communion with thy most pure and life-creating mysteries. I pray thee, O gracious lover of man, preserve me under thy protection, beneath the shadow of thy wings. Enable me, even to my last breath, to partake worthily and with a pure conscience of thy holy things, for the remission of sins and unto life eternal. For thou art the bread of life, the fountain of holiness, the giver of all good. To thee we ascribe glory with the Father and the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages. Amen.
Freely thou hast given me thy body for my food, O thou who art a fire consuming the unworthy, consuming out of my Creator. Let instead enter into my members, my veins, my heart, consume the thorns of my many transgressions. Cleanse my soul and sanctify my reasonings, make firm my knees and body, illumine my five senses, nail me to the fear of thee, always protect, guard, and keep me from soul-destroying words and deeds. Cleanse me, purify me, and adorn me, give me understanding and illumination, show me to be a temple of thy one Spirit, and not the home of many sins. May every evil thing, every carnal passion flee from me as from a fire, as I become thy tabernacle through communion. I offer thee as intercessors all the saints, the leaders of the bodiless host, thy forerunner, the wise apostles, and thy pure and blameless mother. Accept their prayers in thy love, O my Christ, and make me thy servant, a child of light. For thou art the only sanctification and light of our souls, O good one, and to thee, our Master and God, we ascribe glory day by day.
O Lord Jesus Christ, our God, let that holy body be my eternal life, thy precious blood my remission of sins. Let this Eucharist be my joy, health, and gladness. A gift, and therefore thee to stand on the right hand of thy glory, thine awesome second coming, through the prayers of thy most pure mother and of all the saints. O most holy Mary Theotokos, the light of my darkened soul, my hope, my protection, my refuge, my rest, and my joy, I thank you, for you have permitted me, the unworthy, to be a partaker of the most pure body and precious blood of your Son. Give the light of understanding to the eyes of my heart, you that gave birth to the true light. Enlighten me, who am deadened by sin, you that gave birth to the fountain of immortality. Have mercy on me, O loving Mother of the merciful God. Grant me compunction and contrition of heart, humility in my thoughts, and a relief from the slavery of my own reasoning. And enable me, even to my last breath, to receive the sanctification of the most pure mystery, the healing of soul and body. Grant me tears of repentance and confession, that I may glorify you all the days of my life, for you are blessed and greatly glorified forever. Amen.
Lord, now let your servant depart in peace according to your word. For mine eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared before the face of all people, a light to enlighten the Gentiles and the glory of your people Israel.
Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy Immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy Immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy Immortal, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. O most Holy Trinity, have mercy on us. Lord, cleanse us from our sins. Ask for pardon our transgressions. Holy One, visit and heal our infirmities for thy name's sake. Lord of mercy, Lord of mercy, Lord of mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one.
Thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages.
Amen. Grace shining forth from your lips like a beacon has enlightened the universe. It has shown to the world the riches of poverty. It has revealed to us the heights of humility. Teaching us by your words, O Father John Chrysostom, intercede before the Word, Christ our God, to save our souls. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Having received divine grace from heaven, you teach all men to adore the one God in three persons. O all blessed John Chrysostom, we rightly praise you, for you are our teacher, revealing things divine. Now and ever and ever.